Apple's made a watch. This is it. It's okay. Costs a bit. Does some cool things though. Thanks for watching. Okay, so you may have already heard that the Apple Watch is a thing, but you might still be undecided on whether it's worth your time and money. We're gonna try and help you make up your mind. It doesn't pack a circular face like we were hoping, but it is a thing of beauty. The level of fit and finish is right up there with Apple's greatest products, and some of the best in the business, especially when you sit it alongside a few notable rivals. The Sport Edition is the most affordable of the three variants, with its aluminium casing, and it looks particularly good in black. But depending on how deep your pockets go, there's also a stainless steel option and two 18-karat gold variants that can set you back up to five figures. The details really help the Apple Watch stand out though, from the curved glass front that blends into the casing, a magnetic charging dock that connects neatly over the heart rate sensor, and the easily interchangeable straps. Even the larger 42mm body feels smaller than most other smartwatches out there, but it still gives you a big screen experience from a small device. As was already mentioned, a circular screen would have been cool, but Apple has actually given its watch an excellent 390x312 squared retina display all the same. The impressively deep blacks give the illusion that the screen is part of the curved glass front, and if you look at Apple's notes to its developers, it suggests that they should design their apps with a predominantly black UI to sell this idea. It's a wonderfully colourful screen too. Best seen from the apps menu and great auto brightness paired with low reflectivity ensures it's usable indoors or outdoors. Even simple things like the accelerometer have clearly been fine-tuned, as it boasts one of the best takes on tilt-to-wake around, working 99% of the time. The only gripe is that it's not the sharpest in the business, but it is usable for fine text, and images look okay too. WatchOS 2 is right around the corner, but for the time being, the Apple Watch has a few hurdles that it needs to overcome first. Namely that apps, which are the focus of the experience, can take a long time to load, especially when they have to pull your iPhone for information. Aside from being a bit slow though, the Apple Watch is feature-packed, perhaps a little too rich if you don't want to spend the entire day staring at your wrist. Glances help keep selected info to hand, whilst pressing the crown will bring up the complete apps menu, the layout of which you can customise from the companion app on your iPhone. Outside of first-party apps, notifications aren't particularly rich, and coming from Android Wear that feels a little bit restrictive, but on the whole, there's a lot on offer here. Fitness freaks will also appreciate the inbuilt activity tracking, which distills your day into standing, moving, and exercising. The three-ring UI makes it easy to see how you're progressing, and you can even unlock achievements by trying that little bit harder. Smartwatch interaction is a tricky thing to get right, but the Apple Watch gives you a number of ways in which to do it. The digital crown is both a smooth scroll wheel and a back button that's great for scanning through lists quickly, rather than having to swipe and obscure things on screen. The touchscreen supports harder presses too, called force touches, for alternative options like changing your watch face, and there's a second hard key that brings up your favourite contacts, or can be used to switch the watch off completely. Ignore the hearsay if you're worried about battery life. We consistently manage 2 days of use between charges comfortably. And if you want, there's a power reserve mode to push things even further. Charging is also pretty swift, going from 0 to 100% in about an hour, so you're never going to be without your watch for too long. A smart feature that Apple didn't really make a big song and dance about at launch is that when you take the watch off, it enables a PIN code automatically, so it's harder for prying eyes to get at any personal information you might have stashed away. So with all this in mind, should you buy an Apple Watch? Well, maybe. It depends. If you're after a smartwatch and you use an iPhone, your options are really limited to this or the Pebble Time and Time Steel, both of which are more affordable, but this offers a more tailored experience. It's got a lot of room to grow and it still needs work, but mainly on the software side, the easier side to alter and refine. So yes, the Apple Watch is a good smartwatch and it's one of the best cases for the technology yet, even if it doesn't have the power to convince everyone. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, just drop us a line in the comments below. And don't forget to read the full review on recombu.com/mobile. Thanks for watching. These are four of the latest smartwatches out right now, but the question is, should you buy any of them at all? If design is your top priority, we'd recommend Motorola's Moto 360.